Hi, I'm Carrie Cole. I'm a celebrity vocal coach and artist development expert, and I help artists find their voice, craft their music, and create successful music careers. I've worked with Donald Fagen from Steely Dan, Courtney Love from Hole. I've worked with the band Journey. I'm going to teach you how to be a better singer and performer. So I'm going to talk today about common mistakes that singers make. I would say right off the bat, there's four. The first one being pitch. Pitch is non-negotiable. You have to learn to sing on pitch. And learning to sing on pitch requires having an ear, listening to a lot of music, recording yourself a lot. I think recording is the number one way that I correct pitch with singers. Singers hear themselves mostly from inside their inside ear, not from the outer ear. When you cup your ear, you can hear yourself more with the outer ear. And this can cause a lot of mistakes with pitch. So pitch is like a number one non-negotiable issue with singers. If you're not singing on pitch, okay? Phrasing, if you're off time with your phrasing. Phrasing means timing, means rhythm. Some of the best singers in the world were drummers, because their phrasing is so awesome. So getting good phrasing is an important part of really learning how to sing well, and it's a very common mistake that a lot of people make. A lot of people just focus on the notes. It's not just the notes, it's the way you deliver those notes, the rhythm of those notes. A singer is a rhythmic instrument as well as a melodic one. Presentation. I see a lot of people make mistakes with presentation. How you present yourself, how you talk about yourself as a singer, not trying to be more than you are, which gets into the fourth one, which I'll get into in just a minute, but dress the part. If you want to be a rock star, look like a rock star. If you want to be a folky, look like a folky. You know, pay attention to how you're presenting yourself, because you are your brand 24/7. It's not about being inauthentic. It's actually about being very authentic. It's about bringing who you are really to your presentation more. You want to look the part. You want to act the part, dress the part, look the part. Another common mistake is overreaching, trying to do things that are outside of your scope, and, you know, trying to sing like these crazy notes when you don't have them in your voice is not benefiting you. It's not showing anybody that you can do it. You really need to sing the notes that you know you can deliver, and that is a big part of not preparing enough. I feel like because the voice is an instrument that lives in your body and you don't have to go purchase it at the store, it's common for a lot of people just to think that they can sing. And people ask me that quite often, actually, do you think anyone can sing? And I said, if you're asking me on a professional level, I would say, not really. But then we have to look at singers that are not great singers, but that are awesome storytellers or songwriters. So it isn't all about the singing voice. So there's many aspects to that. It's not just a straight up answer, but it's learning how to feature your strengths and downplay your weaknesses. So someone who is really understands what they're good at and learn and brings that to the forefront is going to be more successful than trying to do something that they can't and that they don't have naturally. So those are four common mistakes that beginning singers make.